Hello and welcome. In last lecture, we have seen the characteristic of DNA model proposed by Watson and Crick. The DNA is double-stranded, right-handed helical structure. In today's lecture, we will see how we can draw the double helical structure of DNA. I am Sudhakar and you are watching Science Knowledge with Sudhakar.
In very simple manner, we can draw a double helical structure of DNA. Now, the two strands we have to draw, and these are parallel strands. So, I will take two imaginary lines, and we have to draw the double helical structure in between these two lines. The first strand, it is running from this end. So, I will draw it. So, it is completing one turn, and then another turn. Now second strand we have to draw, which will be parallel to this one. So I will draw parallel. I will start from here and the line will go parallel to the upper line. So this is parallel strand. Then again we have to take turn and go to parallel to this line. Okay, again parallel and again parallel. Now just complete this one. Parallel on this side. Okay. So these two lines, they represent two strands. And these two strands have a sugar phosphate backbone. So this strand, it will have sugar phosphate, and so on. Similarly, here there will be sugar phosphate backbones. The nitrogen bases which are present in these two strands, they forms a complementary pairing. So we will have one pair like this one, second one, third one, fourth, fifth, sixth, seven, eight, nine, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. Now as in each turn there are 10 base pairs, so we have to take the care that during drawing we will have 5 nitrogen base pairs here in half turn and here 5 in another half turn. Okay, now let us name the strands. This strand, if it starts with 5 prime end, one end it is 5 prime end, then the second end of this strand, it is continuous here, it will be 3 prime end. And DNA always runs in 5 prime to 3 prime direction. So it is running downwards. Now what will happen towards the second strand? This end which is present towards 5 prime end, it will be 3 prime end. Because the two strands are anti-parallel. Okay. 3 prime end, it will run down. And the second end of the same strand, it will be 5 prime end. Now this strand, it runs from 5 prime to 3 prime, so it will run upward. Right? One strand is running downward and another strand is running upward, and that is why it is called as anti-parallel organization. So two strands are arranged anti-parallelly. Now, we have to note these two facts. The width is 20 angstrom units. So this width, which is present between these two imaginary points, it is 20 angstrom units. Now let us see what is mean by grooves. Grooves are the deep ends which are created in this structure. Now certain ends are very deep, and these deep structures are called as major groove. These are major grooves. Whereas the shallow one, they are called as minor grooves. Distance between two successive major grooves or two successive minor grooves is called as single pitch. It is called as single turn. So here we will take a single turn on this side. Now we are taking the distance between minor groove and next successive minor groove. So this distance is called as single pitch, or it is also called as single turn. And characteristically, this pitch consists of 10 bass pairs. So here there will be 10 bass pairs. The second characteristic is the height. Height of single pitch is 34 angstrom units. Now, tell me, what will be the distance between two successive bass pairs? Now, how to calculate it? Very simple. A turn, it has height of 34 angstrom units. Single turn. And this single turn, it has 10 bass pairs. So, divided by 10, this will be equal to 3.4 angstrom units. Now, also tell me, angle of two successive bass pairs. These bass pairs, these are arranged like as a stack of book which is turning around itself. So here we can see a stack of books. So we can see that the basal one, it is in the direction of east west. Then the next one is turned little bit. This angle, it is the rotation. Next one again rotated further. And in this way, it is continued to rotate. Book number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Whereas the 11th one, it is just parallel to the first one. First one is facing east-west and the 11th one is again facing east-west. So in this way, they turn by 36 degrees when one bass pair is covered by another bass pair. The 10 bass pairs, they will complete a single turn of 360 degree. Single turn is of 360 degree. It is completed by 10 bass pairs. So the angle between two successive bass pairs, it will be equal to 36 degree. So once again, we will have a revision. Watson and Crick, they have proposed this model in 1953, and for this investigation they have been awarded with Nobel Prize. According to them, this is a polynucleotide. Each nucleotide has a sugar phosphate backbone and nitrogen base pair. The DNA is made up of two strands. Both these strands have a backbone of sugar and phosphate, and they have the steps of this ladder which are made up of nitrogen base pairs. Nitrogen bases shows complementary base pairing. So adenine always pairs with thymine forming two hydrogen bonds, and guanine always pairs with cytosine forming three hydrogen bonds. So these are the hydrogen bonds which gives stability to the double helical structure. That is why the sum total of A plus G is always equal to sum total of T plus C. So this is Chargaff's rule. The next characteristic is that these two strands, they run in opposite direction. If one strand is running downward, then another strand will run upward. And this opposite organization of two strands is called as anti-parallel organization. It will turn in a clockwise direction. So this is a right-handed double helix. Due to this twisting, it produces two types of grooves. Deep grooves, they are called as major grooves, and shallow grooves or minor grooves. Minor and major grooves are present alternate to each other. Distance between two successive minor grooves, or the distance between two successive major grooves, is called as pitch. It is also called as a turn. This single term, it has the height of 34 angstrom units. So this is the height of pitch. Whereas one turn consists of 10 base pairs. Therefore, each base pair, it will be displaced at the distance of 34 angstrom divided by 10 base pairs, that is equal to 3.4 angstrom units. Single turn, it is completed by 10 base pairs. Angle between two successive base pairs, it is 36 degrees. Width of this double helical structure is 20 angstrom units. So these are the characteristics of Watson and Crick's model of DNA. DNA may shows variation from this structure, either in the height of the pitch, number of base pairs, or the width, occurs during abnormal conditions or artificially controlled conditions. Thank you.